Welcome to Academica Lab Solutions. Motorized Transmission Line Trainer, designed by Academica, is an innovative product to teach students the concept of transmission line, like observation of standing wave pattern at different frequencies, analysis of various load condition on the microstrip line, S-parameter measurements, and introduction to plotting a normalized impedance on the Smith chart. This is the list of deliverables. Make sure that you have identified all the components as per the list before you start the installation and experimentation. This is the experimental manual in English, explaining the theory and experimental procedures with observation tables. This is the installable software on CD. Make sure that you install software before performing the experiments. This is the control unit having a PLL synthesized RF signal source which is used to feed as input to the transmission line and a RF detector which detects the RF signal. This unit is interfaced to the PC via USB. This is a motorized microstrip transmission line designed for operation between 250 MHz to 1500 MHz with a characteristic impedance of 50 ohms. The length of the line is 590 mm with a probe sensing resolution of 1 mm. This is a 3-port broadband directional coupler with a directivity of 20 dB and is used for S-parameter measurements. These are the different loads provided with the system like open, short and a 50 ohm termination. Accessories like SMA RG316 RF cables 50 cm and 2 meter each, RS232 cables, USB cable and power cord are provided with the system. Now let's understand electrical connections. Connect the stepper motor marked RS232 connector on the transmission line to the front panel of the control unit. Take the RS232 cable and connect one end to the limit switch marked RS232 connector on the transmission line and the other end to the rear side of the control unit. Now, we will feed the signal from the RF signal generator to the port 1 of the transmission line using a 50 cm SMA RF cable. The output of the sensing probe on the transmission line is connected to the RF detector of the control unit using a 2 meter RF cable. Connect the power cord to the rear side of the control unit and switch it on. A welcome screen appears on the display and by following the procedure as shown, you can configure the control unit to operate in the software control mode. Connect B-type USB to the rear side of the control unit and the A-type to any one of the port on the PC. The electrical connection is now complete and open the software by clicking the MMTLT icon on the PC. The software screen opens, go to the PC mode and then select the correct COM port. Now the training system is ready for experimentation. Experiment number 1. Characteristics of transmission line for different load termination. Open the software and select the transmission line parameter as shown. The resolution is set to 1 mm and frequency is set to 900 MHz. Connect the 50 ohm load to port 3 of the transmission line and click the run button on the software. The sensor probe, port 2, will be moving along the transmission line in the forward direction. While moving, the sensor probe will measure the power at every 1 mm distance on the transmission line. Once the sensor probe reaches the end of the transmission line, it automatically returns to its home position because of the limit switch provided on the transmission line. Now, the software will plot the standing wave graph at a frequency of 900 MHz. Now position the marker M1 to the second minima and marker M2 to third minima. The software screen displays the power and distance. Now enter the impedance of transmission line Z0 at 900 MHz as 26 ohms. This impedance is derived from the annexure as shown. This is the impedance value of transmission line with load, short, and open termination, measured on VNA at different frequencies like 800, 900, and 1000 MHz. Now, click on the summary button to display all the parameters of the transmission line. Since we know Pmax and Pmin, we can calculate Vmax and Vmin. Then, the VSWR is calculated using the formula Vmax divided by Vmin. We see that the VSWR is around 2, which means that there is less mismatch between the source and the load. Then, the reflection coefficient is calculated using the formula VSWR minus 1 divided by VSWR plus 1. This is the magnitude value, and we can convert it to dB value to get the return loss using the formula as shown in the screen. The return value displayed is around minus 9 dB, which means 90% power transmitted and only 10% will be reflected back, which is in the acceptable range. The load impedance can be calculated as we now know the value of tau and Z0. The load impedance that we have experimentally calculated is 55 ohms as seen on the software screen, which is very close to the 50 ohms termination that we had connected to the transmission line. Hence, theoretical value and practical values are verified. Now, we remove the load termination and connect the open termination to the transmission line. Click on the run button. After the transmission line has traversed the entire length, the graph is plotted on the software. Measure the two successive minima as shown in the software. Set the Z0 parameter to 46 ohms, refer annexure, and click on the summary to get the results. From the graph and the calculations, we see that RL is around minus 3 dB, which means 50% signal is reflected back. We see that the calculated ZL is having high impedance, approximately 300 ohms, which means that the line is not matched. Theoretically, a transmission line with open termination has high impedance, which is proven by this experiment. Now, as shown, you can save this graph for future reference and comparison. Now, remove the open termination and connect the short termination to the transmission line. Click the run button. After the transmission line has traversed the entire length, the graph is plotted on the software. Measure the two successive minima as shown in the software. Set the Z0 parameter to 3 ohms, reference annexure, and click on the summary to get the final results. From the graph and the calculations, we see that RL is approximately minus 3 dB, which means 50% of the signal is reflected back. We see that the calculated ZL is having low impedance, approximately 17 ohms, which means that it is not matched. Theoretically, a transmission line with short termination has low impedance, which is proved by this experiment. You can save this graph for future reference and comparison. You can also compare the standing wave graph for open termination and short termination. It is clearly seen that there is a phase shift of 180 degrees between the peaks of open and short termination. Experiment number 2. Measurement of incident and reflected wave in a transmission line. Open the software as shown. Select the incident and reflected wave option in the software. The resolution is set to 5 mm and frequency is set to 275 MHz. Connect the open termination to port 3 of the transmission line. Click the run button on the software. The sensor probe will start moving along the transmission line, and after completion of the traverse, it will display the distance versus power graph. The yellow plot represents the incident wave and red plot represents the reflected wave of the transmission line. You see that more power, approximately 6 dBm, is reflected back to the source as the line is open. Also, you see the power of the incident wave is reduced as the distance increases. In this case, we see a power of 16 dBm at a distance of 50 mm and a reduced power of 5 dBm at a distance of 550 mm. Experiment number 3. Calculation of the unknown frequency of the transmission line. Open the software and select the transmission line parameter as shown. The resolution is set to 1 mm and frequency is set to 900 MHz. The software is run with transmission line in open condition. The sensor probe will start moving along the transmission line, and after completion of the traverse, it will display the graph which plots the standing wave pattern. The two successive minima will give you lambda g by 2 value. From this, we can calculate the unknown frequency is equal to c divided by lambda g multiplied by 1.94. Now, just by changing the input frequency to say 500 MHz and 1200 MHz, you will get different standing wave pattern, and from this, you can calculate the frequency. Experiment number 4, S-parameter measurements. Open the software, as shown, go to the S-parameter S11 option. Set the start frequency to 250 MHz and stop frequency to 1500 MHz and click Run. For the forward power measurement, make the connections as shown in display. RF signal generator to in port of directional coupler, RF detector port to CPL port of directional coupler, out port of directional coupler to port 1 of transmission line. Then a 50 ohm low termination is connected to the port 3 of the transmission line. Once these connections are done, run the software. The system records this reading in its internal memory and then prompts for the reflected power measurement. Just reverse the connections in the in port and out port of the directional coupler and then run the software. The software plots the frequency versus power graph, which is the S11 of the transmission line. Set the marker M2 at 290 MHz and M1 at 1250 MHz. From this graph, we infer that over the operating band of this transmission line, the reflection coefficient S11 parameter is below minus 9 dB, which means only 10% of the power is reflected back and remaining 90% power is transmitted through the port 1. Click on the VSWR button to plot the VSWR at different frequencies. The graph shows VSWR value for the entire band of frequency. Click on the impedance button to plot the impedance at different frequencies. Experiment number 5. Plotting normalized impedance on Smith chart. Open the software and select the operating mode to Smith chart. As performed in experiment number 1, calculate the load impedance of the transmission line ZL at different frequencies like 800 MHz, 900 MHz and 1000 MHz with matched load condition. Note ZL. This would be approximately ZL is equal to 60 ohms at 800 MHz, ZL is equal to 54 ohms at 900 MHz, ZL is equal to 56 ohms at 1000 MHz. Use these readings to fill the normalized impedance table. For entering the normalized impedance table at 800 MHz, enter ZL as 60 ohms and Z0 as 50 ohms and click the calculate button to calculate the Z norm value, which is the real part. The imaginary part, JX, is given in the lookup table below. The calculated R is entered as 1.2 and JX as 0.4 in the normalized impedance table. The same procedure is followed to get the R and JX at 900 MHz and 1200 MHz. Once all the value are entered, click the Run button. The software displays the Smith chart plot. The topmost point on the Smith chart shows the normalized impedance at 800 MHz with matched load. The center point on the Smith chart shows the normalized impedance at 900 MHz with matched load. The bottom point on the Smith chart shows the normalized impedance at 1000 MHz with matched load.